Hello everyone, welcome back to the video lecture series on Geotechnical Engineering with me, Nihal Naveen. So today we are going to start with the new chapter, that is stress distribution in soils. Okay, we'll cover this chapter in two parts and it is a very short chapter, and generally objective questions are asked from this chapter. Okay, so you need to study this, you need to focus on this. So let's begin. Stress distribution in soil. Okay. Now there are two theories in this case. First is given by Bosnisk, and the second is the Westergaard theory. Okay, Bosnisk is more on the conservative side, and Westergaard is for, it also considered the, it is for isotropic actually. Okay. And this Westergaard is generally for non-isotropic. That means the variables are different, properties are different. So, and generally, practically, Bosnisk theory is more common to find the stress value at a point. So, let's look at this theory. If Q load is applied, okay, and on the surface at point O, this is the point O. Now, we have to find the stress at point P. Now, this point P is located at a distance of R from the perpendicular, okay, and at a depth of Z. Now this value is Z. Now naturally it will be located at R square plus Z square. Pythagoras, you can find this will be the displacement of point P. Okay. Now this, he gave the theory as sigma Z is equal to, that is effective stress at this point P, as 3 by 2 pi 1 by 1 plus R by Z whole square whole to the power 5 by 2 into Q by Z square. Okay. Now this whole term is taken as KB, okay, that is Bosnisk coefficient, okay, into Q by Z square. Okay, so sigma Z is KB into Q by Z square. You have to remember this formula, though it may seem confusing here, but you have to, once or twice you will look, you will just remember this. Okay, and this KB is Bosnisk influence factor. Okay, this is the coefficient given by Bosnisk. And sometimes it's directly given, that influence factor in the question is given, and area value is given, that is Z square is given. So you have to find the stress. You will directly use IF, that is influence factor, into Q by Z square. And that IF is nothing else but KB. Okay.
Subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to never miss any update. From Cradock.
Now let's see some of the assumptions that Bosnisk took in this theory. He considered this soil as homogeneous, isotropic, as I told that the properties will be same in all the directions, and semi-infinite, okay, and elastic. That semi-infinite means depth is finite and area is infinite, and elastic state. Both these are elastic theories. Bosnisk and Westergaard's both are based on elastic theories. Now Hooke's law is valid here, that is stress is directly proportional to strain. The third assumption is self weight of soil above that concerned point is neglected. Now this is the point, above this point if some self weight is acting, naturally it will be acting, that will be neglected in Bosnisk theory. The fourth assumption is change in volume of soil due to application of load is also neglected. Now, when you apply load on the soil, naturally we will observe a volumetric strain, and that strain is neglected in our case, in Bosnisk theory. The fifth assumption is distribution of stresses is symmetrical about the vertical axis. Okay, about the vertical axis, in both these directions you have stresses symmetrical. Okay, like this. If this is the vertical axis, both will be symmetrical. A top surface of soil is free from shear stress and subjected to normal stress. Shear stress value is not considered here. We have to focus only on normal stress and we have to find the stress which is acting at this point due to load Q. This Q is in kilonewton, capital Q. Okay. So don't confuse this. Q is in not stress. This is stress, sigma Z, denoted by kilonewton per meter square, and this Q value will be in kilonewton. That means load will be given and you have depth will be given. You have to find at which depth you have to get the value of stress. Okay. Now this radial stress, when this was the normal stress value, okay, sigma z, and radial stress value that will be given as this, okay, Q by 2 pi 3 z r square by r 5 minus 1 minus 2 mu. This is Poisson's ratio, okay, Poisson's ratio of soil, r by r plus z, okay. So vertical stress you don't find, it is dependent on soil material. So it does just depends on r by z value, okay, that is radius and depth value. And but in case of radial stress, it also depends on Poisson's ratio. So it depends on material of the soil. This is the basic difference between vertical stresses and radial stresses. Okay, vertical stress is independent of soil materials, that is E and mu. Now this vertical stress, it can be shown by an isobar diagram. Now what are isobars? It is actually a curve which joins points of equal vertical pressure. That means here we will have the same pressure as this, okay, because it depends on r by z value. Naturally it may be equal, this value might be equal to this, because r value is different from this value, though the z value is more here. So stress isobar is a curve joining the points of equal vertical pressure in the soil mass, okay, as I told. This isobar is a curved surface, and as you can see, it resembles an onion, okay, the onion shape. This is the onion, okay. So it is also known as pressure bulb, and generally you have layers in onion, so you have bulb like structure, so it is also known as pressure bulb. Now let's see vertical stress distribution diagram on horizontal plane, okay. First we will take on horizontal plane, and then we will take on vertical line. In horizontal plane, by horizontal plane we means that z value, that is depth value, will remain fixed and r will vary, that means radius will vary. So we will get first put the values and just find the value of kb and sigma z. So r by z value is 0, that means the point is lying just below the point of application. That means this is r, okay, this was the point. Now this point is present here itself, okay, p dash. So naturally r value will be 0. So this whole ratio also becomes 0. So this kb value, okay, this kb value will be, you will get as 3 by 2 pi 1 by 1 plus r by z whole square to the power 5 by 2, okay, that is 3 by 2 pi 1 by 1 plus r by z whole square to the power 5 by 2. Now this value is 0. Now naturally we will have 3 by 2 pi. Now this 3 by 2 pi, This will be the kb value at, that is influence factor at, Poisson's influence factor at r by z value 0. So that value will be 0.4775. Okay, you don't need to remember this, just you can calculate and get it from the calculator, okay. And sigma z, it will be kb into q by z square, so just multiply it by q by z square and get the stress at this point, okay, that is just below the application of load. Now as you go on increasing, you will find that this kb value goes on decreasing, okay, because r by z is present on the denominator side. So you get this value as 0.273, and if you use a ratio as 1, 0.084, and 2 we have very less, that is 0.008, okay, that the value is decreasing. So just you see how you will get the curve. Assume this is the center, you will get a curve like this. Okay, this is the maximum value, 0.4775 q by z square, okay, at r by z 0. This let it be the r by z values, this at 0, and then we have at, let's say we have taken at 0.5, 1 and 2 we have very less, that is 0.008 q by z square. So you will get a pattern like this, okay, it will be more at the point. Here we are keeping, remember that here we are keeping z is fixed, so this z value z value will be fixed. Okay, so don't confuse, only r is varying here. So naturally when r is 0, that means the load is just above that point. So naturally the stress will be more. So we have the maximum stress at this O point, that is 0. So let's now see the case for vertical line, when vertical distribution occurs. That is, r is fixed and here z is varying. Okay, so this q is applied and r is fixed here. Okay, this was r. Okay, let's say r is fixed here, let's say this point, and we are varying the depth, that is we are going downwards. Okay, now see how this change occurs. It is found that this vertical stress value first increases with depth. First it increases, okay, and then it reaches a maximum value, that is this point, and again it decreases further. Now it goes on decreasing. Okay, now here we have the sigma z value in this axis, and here we have the z, that is depth, and r is fixed here. R is fixed, radius is fixed. Now you can get the maximum value using differentiation. You can get it. Okay, that is, with respect to z you have to differentiate, and you will get the value as r by z as under root of 2/3. You have to remember this value, where you are getting the maximum value, the ratio where you are getting the maximum value for vertical stress, it will be 0.817. And you can put this value in that formula, and that is sigma z is equal to 3q by 2 pi 1 by 1 plus r by z ka whole square whole to the power 5/2. Now you put this r by z value 0.817 here, and you can get the value as 0.00888 q by r square. Okay, you can get this value. So just remember this, maximum value at which you obtained is sigma z max. And you can get this tan theta value also, where maximum stress is acting, that tan theta value is, this theta value is actually 39°15". Okay, just remember this. That is, r by z value tan theta is equal to under root of 2/3. You can get theta value from here, tan inverse 39°15". Now taking the Westergaard's theory, how it is different from this Bosnian's theory? He gave this theory as sigma z is equal to, this value remains same, q by z square, only the coefficients have changed. Here it is replaced by kw, that is Westergaard coefficient, Westergaard influence factor. It is given as 1 by pi 1 by 1 plus 2 into r by z to the power 2 whole to the power 3/2. Instead of 5/2, it came 3/2, and here 2 is extra. Instead of 3q by 2 pi or 3/2 pi, we have 1 by pi. Okay. So, in generally, in questions, you have asked the objective questions, either 1 marks generally. So, you are asked the ratios of these stresses using Bosnian's and Westergaard. So, just you find these, how it is, if it is given the depth has increased by twice or radius increased by thrice, then just you compare the ratios and get the stress values. Okay, now the assumptions, let's see what are the assumptions in Westergaard. Here the medium is assumed to be homogeneous, same as that. Semi-infinite was also the same in Bosnian's, elastic and non-isotropic. Here the medium is non-isotropic, that means it is not conservative, actually it is, the properties are changing in different directions, so it is non-isotropic, Westergaard's theory. And this, the medium is considered to be rigid horizontally, that means the lateral strain will be zero in horizontal direction and elastic vertically. So naturally mu value, mu is the Poisson's ratio. You know that Poisson's ratio is the ratio of lateral strain by longitudinal strain. So lateral strain in lateral direction, naturally it is rigid. So lateral strain will be zero. So you will get the Poisson's ratio as zero in case of Westergaard. Now vertical stress just below the point load, r is equal to zero. It is given as r by z is equal to zero, and sigma z value is 0.318. Okay. You can just put the value r is equal to 0 here, and you just 1 by pi, you will get this value as 0.318, which is less. In case of Bosnius, we had 0.4775, okay, and we are getting this value as less as compared to Bosnius. So just remember. Now let's see the comparison between Bosnius and Westergaard's theory, how they are comparable. Now first let's find the value of R by Z, that is the ratio at which we get equal effective stresses values at Z depth for both the Bosnius and Westergaard's conditions. Okay, just we are equating this KB into Q by Z square is equal to KW into Q by Z square. Okay, naturally this will cancel. Now KB, what we have? KB is equal to KW. KB we have 3 by 2 pi 1 by 1 plus R by Z whole square to the power 5 by 2. And what we have the value of KW? 1 by pi 1 by 1 plus 2 times R by Z whole square whole to the power 3 by 2. Now when you equate these two values, you will find that R by Z value you obtained as 1.52. Now at this value, you will find that both the answers from Bosnius and Westergaard theory, we have the same value of stresses. Okay, and you may also draw the graph for different values of R by Z, also in case of Westergaard as we did for Bosnius. So finally, you will get the relation as we draw it for, this was for Bosnius, and for Westergaard, you will find this as like this. Okay, so this is for 0, R by Z value is 0. And here, where both the values, effective stress values are same, that value is, R by Z value is 1.52. Okay. So, if we go on above this, we find that the effective stress due to Westergaard is greater. This is for Westergaard and this one is for Bosnius. Okay. Don't confuse. Okay, so this value we got as 0.4775 Q by Z square, and this value we got as 0.318, I guess. Yes, 0.318 Q by Z square. Okay, so just remember these two. Now, the results obtained from Westergaard equation are more realistic. Why? Because we are taking the non-isotropic condition in Westergaard's. And in Bosnius, it is more conservative, as I told. So, hence Bosnius theory is practically used for computation of vertical stresses. And we don't generally use the Westergaard because it becomes complex actually. And as the soil is non-isotropic in nature, as the assumption is non-isotropic. Okay. So, let's take a numerical from previous year gate. It was asked in year 2010. Let's read the question. The vertical stress at point P1 due to load, point load Q, okay, is the point P1. Now, Q load is applied here, okay, on the ground surface as shown in figure is sigma z. Now, here we are getting the stress as sigma z. According to Bosnius equation, the vertical stress at point P2, now P2 is this. Now, here it is located at distance of z, depth of z and radius r. And point P2 is located at depth of z by 2 and radius r by 2, okay. Now, you have to find this vertical stress at P2 in terms of stress at P1. How will find it? As I told, the ratio questions are generally asked. So, just use this. Sigma Z1 is equal to 3Q by 2 pi 1 by 1 plus R by Z whole square to the power 5 by 2. Okay. This was the original case. And sigma Z2 we have 3Q by into Q by Z square. Okay. And here we have the value as 3Q by 2 pi. This Q value we have already taken here. 1 by 1 plus R by 2 by Z by 2. Okay. According to your question, whole square to the power 5 by 2 into 1 by Z square. okay. Yes, if I am not able to see, I am reading 1 by z square here it is. Q I have already taken here, okay. So just divide these two, okay. This value will cancel, okay. All these constants will cancel. And you will be left with this z. Z will be z by 2 whole square, okay. Because it is lying at a depth of z by 2. So naturally, sigma z1 by sigma z2 will be 1 by z square by 1 by z by 2 whole square. We will be left only with this value. So naturally, sigma z2 will be 4 times of sigma z1. Okay. So if value was sigma z here, so we have 4 sigma z at value at point P2. So our correct option is option D. So moving on to our next question. This was asked in year 2017. A uniformly distributed line load, okay, uniformly distributed, it is given, of 500 kilonewton per meter is acting on the ground surface, okay. Now, based on Bosnes' theory, the ratio of vertical stress at a depth 2 meter to that at 4 meter, right below the line of loading, okay, right below the line of loading, you have to find the value, okay. Actually, this question, uniformly distributed line load, you haven't studied now, you will be studying this in next video. But I am telling you here, it's the value. Just you have to remember the value of the coefficient. It is given as sigma z1 is equal to 2q by pi z. Okay, here you don't have to use pi z square. Okay, because here we are using unit load. This q will be in terms of kilonewton per meter. Okay, not only kilonewton. There we were using capital Q, that is kilonewton in terms of load. Okay. So, 2q by z, 1 by 1 plus, it is x by z whole square to the power 2. This will be the value, okay? So, just you have to find the ratio when the stress is at depth 2 meter to that at 4 meter. So, naturally, you find that this is acting on the ground surface and it is also given this. We have to find the stress at just below the line of loading. So, this x value will be 0 here. Okay. Just x value is same as r value. Is lying just below the point of loading. So, this value will naturally become 0. So, only we have the relation between sigma z1 by sigma z2 will only depend on z value. Okay. That is sigma z1 by sigma z2 is equal to z2 by z1. Okay. Because it is that inversely proportional to depth. So, sigma z1 at 2 by sigma z2, z at 4 meter, 2 meter and 4 meter, you have to find the ratio. It will be 4 by 2. That means 2 is the correct answer. So, we have option C. Okay. So, we come to the end of this video. Hope you enjoyed it and gained enough info from it. In the upcoming video, we'll be continuing this chapter, this topic, and we'll be studying about different cases in case of Bosnes and Westergaard theory, like different distribution of load in uniformly case, in uniformly distributed case, line load, strip loading, and circular case loading also, okay. And we'll also be studying about different indirect methods in this case of finding the stress distribution. So, all the best, and you can also practice free quizzes at GradeUp and be a grade higher. Thank you.